would like to remind you that flash photography is prohibited and all mobile phones should be switched off. Please be aware that this show will contain strobe lighting and the scenes of sexual nature. Thank you and enjoy the show.
Ready when I switch to Clara, right, Moses? Some hotel.
And I'm telling you, it don't even matter. I got
everybody got plans.
No, everybody got dreams. I got plans. The men in this town live and die in our gun, and it doesn't seem to scare them. I can't wait to get away, away from the drought and the homeless and the hungry, where they talk about foreclosures every hot and dusty day.
You ain't gotta worry about me, because I've been in jail.
I know plenty of men who've been to jail.
How many of you know busted out?
Well, what were you in for?
Auto theft, robbery, a few things. I like to keep busy. So what do you say? Give me a lift to West Dallas.
Okay.
You and this world will remember. Take it easy. I was never here. Oh, give me a purse.
Evening, ladies.
Evening, Sheriff.
I'm here about your husband, Marvin, a.k.a. Buck Bauer. Have you seen him?
Oh, now since he got himself arrested, I don't have no room for a man like that in my life. You'll find him sitting in McLennan County Jail.
No, you won't.
What?
He should be sitting there, but he ain't.
What?
Your husband and his brother got in their mind to escape.
What?
If you hear anything from your husband or anything about his whereabouts, you call the Dallas County Sheriff's Department straight away. You hear?
Of course.
You have a good evening. Sorry to interrupt your happiness, ladies.
Oh, baby, baby, you're fantastic.
I'm having a heart attack. They're not going to stop looking, Buck.
They never do.
That's right.
They're going to get him.
They ain't never going to find me. Not if we go someplace. Maybe New Mexico.
How romantic.
How beautiful. gonna get him.
You always talk about you want to go away, start fresh.
This wouldn't be going to New Mexico. It'd be running from West Dallas.
She's got a point. Still, I hear it's New Mexico real nice.
They're gonna get you.
You wanna be like your brother, always running from the law, always looking over your shoulder. I love you, Daddy. I love you more than life itself, but we cannot start fresh like that.
You tell him, Blanche.
You started fresh when you were free in the eyes of the law and saved in the eyes of God.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. We can spend our whole lives hiding. Fuck. That ain't no way to leave. It is time to wipe the slate clean. Ask the good Lord to forgive.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
You gotta serve your sentence without fame. Fuck, you are going back to jail.
Now you're talking.
Somewhere with payroll. You know, gas station, grocery store. Can't do nothing without cash. Once I got that, I can hightail it to another state. Cops can't cross the state lines and they ain't gonna be looking for me in Ohio or New York. After that, I'm a free man. I can do whatever I want. And you know what?
What?
You gonna come with me.
What makes you so sure?
The smile.
Just cause I'm smiling, just
talking about mine.
Anyway. I gotta get home and you wanna see your folks.
That can wait. What are you writing?
Poem.
Home, what kind of poem?
County's gonna be published.
Wow.
You get to see my face in the magazines and my poetry by Bonnie Parker, and a beautiful picture of me to go alongside it, like this one. That is what you call a glamour shot.
That is the best picture I've seen in my entire life.
It's a little old now, but I'm gonna get a new one in a nice hat. I look good in hats. I got a hat face.
Bring me your phone.
You like poetry?
I like anything that comes out of your mouth.
Okay. Billy rode on a pinto horse. Billy the Kid, I mean.
I love Billy the Kid.
I know. And he met Clyde Barrow riding in a little gray machine.
You wrote a poem about me? Oh, you are so
You're gonna interrupt me in every line.
I'm sorry.
I can't read if you're gonna do that.
I am
There's
sorry.
There's a rhythm, a flow to these things.
My lips are sealed.
I appreciate the enthusiasm.
My lips are sealed.
Billy said to the barrel boy, "Is this the way you ride? In a car that does its 90 perp machine guns at each side." I only had my pinto horse and my 6-gun tried and true. I could shoot, but they got me, and someday they will get you.
What are you writing that for? That's a lousy thing to write.
It's dramatic.
It's stupid.
Don't you ever call my poetry stupid.
Well, it is when you write things
Don't
like that.
Don't you ever call my poetry stupid.
I know they ain't going to catch me. I'm so far away from this miserable place. They never going to catch up to me. Then I'll be
Don't
in charge.
Man, I want you right now.
Should have thought of that before you called my poetry stupid. Don't laugh at me!
I'm sorry.
Don't you ever laugh at me. I'm gonna be famous. I'm gonna be a poet, an actress, and a singer.
Singer, huh? Sing me something.
I'm not in the mood.
Oh, come on, sugar. I want to hear you sing. Unless that's also about me getting shot up. Come on. You're in a nightclub. Out there in that Atlantic City. Me and Capone are sitting ringside and the crowd is going crazy. Bonnie.
How about a drink? It's always fun. Come over.
Tent for 3 years.
Well, Clyde, you may stay on the sofa. There's an extra sheet in the bedroom, but I'm afraid we don't have an extra blanket or pillow.
That's all right.
And Bonnie, I'll expect you up very shortly.
Okay, Mama.
Almost immediately.
Mama,
your husband will be home, you know.
You got a husband?
I have.
That is something you should tell a fellow.
He went to jail about 3 years ago.
Still there?
No, he's just not interested in being a husband. Is this really what you want to talk about right now?
I'm not in the mood. You expecting company?
No.
Oh, shit, it's the laws. Okay, maybe tomorrow morning, 8 a.m., 145 Oak Grove, okay? Whistle or throw something, second floor window on the corner.
Falling some late on prison break. Figure since I was in the area, I'll stop by. Make sure me and Mama are okay.
We're fine, thanks, Ted.
Jeez. Last time I was in this house when your grandma died.
Oh, well, that was a long time ago.
No, it's the first time I saw a dead body. I mean, she was all made up and everything, but you still see she was dead.
Oh. Well, I hate to see her like that.
I remember how you hid under the front porch.
Eating buttermilk pie.
Playing cards. So I'll pick you up at 7.
Ted, I was me.
And you keep that door locked, yeah?
All right, Ted.
Just to see how un-Christian you can be in the bedroom, Mrs. Barrow.
Now, Daddy, you push that mouth of yours.
I'm going to miss that over the next 8 months.
The time really is going to fly by, you'll see. And I work. The salon's still busy. No matter how hard things get, women still find time to get their hair done. Well, Eleanor's kids haven't seen real milk in over a year. But that woman still gets her hair done every 2 months.
I love you, Blanche.
And I love you, Daddy. What in God's name?
Oh, it's Clyde.
Marvin Ivan Barrow, are you using our home as a criminal rendezvous point?
It's only Clyde.
Which means you're using our home as a criminal rendezvous point. I want him out of here as soon as possible, you hear?
He's my brother.
That man puts the hell in hello. You're like children when you're flying rocks in secret knots.
Hey. Like shit.
I slept in the woods. You seen the paper today?
No, why? Book and Clyde on Barrow Time. What the hell's that supposed to mean?
It means that we make the front page headline right alongside Al Capone.
Oh, dang!
You remember when we saw Al Capone ride through town that afternoon in that,
White Model T Roadster.
Yeah,
he's gonna be us one day, Buck. Driving that open road in a Model T. Or maybe a picture of one of them MGs they got over in Europe. Say they got a 4-speed gearbox that can take you up to speeds of 65 miles per hour.
Dang!
No car too smart for me. Got the whole thing figured out. Two-door hardtop Model T. Pull in the Z, no runabout.
They've been arresting us since we was kids.
That's true.
You've been stealing since you were kids.
Even when we didn't. How many times they come by our tent and haul us out for no damn reason?
Plenty.
And when I worked over at Macy's.
For a week.
They came and pat me down right in front of the customers. How's a man supposed to keep a job? It don't matter what we do. The law is always going to keep coming after us.
Not if you seek forgiveness.
The sheriff don't give a rat's ass about no forgiveness.
Forgiveness from the Lord, Clyde. That is the only thing that will truly set you free.
I ain't never gonna be set free, Blanche. Freedom is something I gotta steal. What's it gonna be, Buck?
I'm gonna go back to prison.
What you gonna do when you get out? You gonna come back here? You gonna work? What you gonna do?
You gonna pick up scrap metal for 3 cents a load? Or maybe with Pa at the gas station, praying someone's still rich enough to own a car stops by. And what you gonna eat, huh? I'm gonna be in control of my life out there on the open road. You have a nice time in that cage. Let's go, Sherry.
Maybe your brother's got the right.
My brother can do what the hell he wants! Clyde Barrow will never sit inside a prison again.
I mean, he can settle down and get a job. I want you to be a man, honey, not a thug.
Don't you ever speak to me that way again.
Don't you ever raise a hand to me, baby.
My advice to you is to stay far away from my man. Don't look at me like that, Jack. You know I'm right. If Clyde wants to descend to the depths of hell, he doesn't need to drag anyone else down there with him. Not you, not me, or that poor misguided trash he picked up last night. You let it run.
son. Take you off the trigger. Put the gun on the ground and slide it over.
Crying.
pray the good Lord brings my daddy home to me tomorrow.
I will.
Blanche.
What?
I just hate to see you get hurt, honey.
I'm not gonna.
Well, that man of yours has been in and out of jail 10 times.
Second.
All I'm saying is just...
Eleanor, I asked you to pray not to judge if you can do that.
Charlie says nothing gonna be able to keep me out another week.
Veronica Carmen says she saw you get on the bus to Eagle Rock yesterday. Where'd you go?
It must have been someone else. Who?
No, she was sure it was you.
I really don't see how that could be possible.
Why are you lying to me, Bonnie? What is so awful that it's causing my daughter to lie to her mama?
I'm in love, Mama.
You're married.
You and me both know Roy ain't ever coming back. And I wouldn't want him even if he did.
Well, how do you meet a boy that lives in Eagle Rock?
He doesn't live there. He's just staying there for a short time.
There's nothing in Eagle Rock except the... Bonnie Parker, are you flirting with a convict?
I'm not flirting.
What is going through your head?
I love him, Mama.
You love who? Who do you love?
Clyde Barrow.
Clyde Barrow. The boy who spent the night in our home. You said he was heading up north to a job.
I love him, Mama.
You don't know him, and what you do know ain't so good, Bonnie.
I do know him. I know everything.
He is a convict that you met a few months ago.
Well, you always said you and Daddy were love at first sight.
Do not compare some convict to your father. Your daddy was a fine, upstanding citizen. He earned a good living, was a good father to you, and a good husband to me, so don't you ever compare some convict to your father. I will see you at home.
Yourself in, we're releasing you into the custody of your wife, Blanche Caldwell Barrow.
And
Rochester bound. You've been found guilty of 7 counts of robbery over $50.
What does that mean?
And they hereby sentence to receive 2 years on each count.
Plus an additional
2 for your attempted escape. Make it a total of 16 years at Eastern Penitentiary.
No! No!
No!
Don't hurt my
child! Don't you I think this sends out a strong message that in these times of victory, we will not tolerate violence of any kind. I remember serving 16 years hard labor in Eastern Penitentiary.
Away from me.
Who? Ed Crowder? He seems like a nice enough fella to me.
He's a model prisoner.
I'm begging you, you know what he's doing to me.
Ed Crowder's just being friendly. He likes you. You should take that as a compliment.
I can't take no more of this. This nightmare has to end in this godforsaken place. Death would be a welcome friend. I could pay a crooked god to kill me. Yeah, that's it. Better that than 16 years dying slowly up in my bed.
There's a gun. Get it for me.
What seems to be the problem?
Look at him!
Yeah? Heard he took a pretty bad fall down the stairs to the yard.
That doesn't happen from a fall. Something like that doesn't happen from an accident.
Visiting time is over.
Get your hands off of me!
Just give me what I asked for,
baby. I'll take care of the rest. Every day!
I'll be back to get you later. And Crowder wants to see you again.
He'll see me. Oh,
shoes and a bow.
Thanks. I don't know what he would do without you. You're his one ray of sunshine in his whole life.
That a waitress from Rowena would have had the balls to bust me out with my old 45. And who would have thought that a farm boy from Toledo could outsmart the smartest lawman and walk out of here?
Stop.
basketball, can you please leave the auditorium during this time?
Shut up!
You got a safe?
You sure?
It's me, Register.
Open.
I'm coming as fast as I can.
Hurry up.
My hands are shaking.
Move and I'll shoot.
Jesus.
Raise your hands and put the gun down.
Can't put the gun down if I'm raising my hands.
You know what I mean. Put the gun down and then raise your hands.
What if I say no?
Everybody, nobody move!
Looks like we got ourselves a standoff.
Drop the weapon.
You really think you got what it takes to pull that trigger?
You really want to find out?
No, I'm going to walk out of here.
Not going to happen.
Deputy,
drop the gun!
Gets hurt.
What happened, Clyde?
A grocery store and some stupid idiot cop that comes in and tries to play
Clyde?
Hero. He had his gun right on me. I had no time. It was him or me, Sugar.
I can't stay.
Barney, please.
I gotta get out now while I still can. While I'm still in the clear.
Barney!
The dream is done. It's over now. Gonna get me out of here.
Don't say that. We're both in shock. We need to think this through. It ain't my fault. I had no choice. Gonna hit. Easy money, in, out. Nobody gets hurt.
I figure we can rob our first bank next week. I'm scouting a few places. I'll try to stay in touch and find a way to see you and the folks. Your brother Clyde. You see, say what you want about Clyde, but he never forgets family.
You could ask him to try harder.
Don't you ever just want a little bit?
Want what?
You know, all the things we can't have.
I have everything I want, and it pains me that you don't, Daddy.
I've got everything I want. There's still other things I want. And I want to give you everything in the world.
Now you stop that. I don't have no room for everything in the world.
Nice clothes, good food, someone doing your hair, a fine bed.
I mean it, Daddy, stop.
Think about it, children. Find anything we want. It's the American dream.
I ain't interested in no American dream. It's an ordinary love. Easy days and quiet nights. Lazy walk beside a stream. Now that's what you call a dream. No ideas and no big plans. Happy just the way things are. Go on with a scam or scheme. Now that's what you call a dream. These dreams of yours make no sense at all. It's what's inside now.
Come on.
worried sick about you.
I won't hurt you.
And Bonnie.
Where are the papers?
The paper said that you killed a police officer. I don't know you anymore, do I not, since you went to that jail?
It was him or me.
Oh. You can't stay around here anymore. The police are looking for you.
But I want to meet you again.
No, I don't think I can.
Come on, please. I can get a message to Paul.
No.
Shoot, he's just saying that because you got the gun. Now which do you like better?
Now my partner is going to approach the counter with a bag that I would very much for like you to fill the cash.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
You not see that gun, miss?
I can't fill your bag with cash because there isn't any.
This here's a bank, ain't it?
Yes, but...
What's going on here?
Closed.
Then what are all these people doing?
We're trying to get out our money.
They're saying the bank is broke.
There's not a nickel in the drawers.
You're telling me that I'm robbing a bank with no money. You own every piece of land in the county. Everybody's home and everyone's damn farm. How can you have no money?
And who are we going to sell the farms to? Nobody can afford to buy them.
I should shoot you right now.
Come on, Clyde.
The stupidity. I lived in a tent for 3 miserable years, and the bank came and took the homes of everybody I know.
It took mine!
No money. In a bank.
Clyde!
What the hell is this country coming to?
Four people.
And we're printing her press like she's Emily Frickin' Dickinson. We look like fools, gentlemen. I got a warden who can't keep him from jail, and I got a sheriff who can't catch him even when they escape.
Governor and all fellas.
Fairness? Two civilians and two police officers are dead, and the public opinion is that Bonnie and Clyde are heroes? There is no fairness.
Hey, Governor, I swear you're on the train.
I have read your reports. You have no idea where the hell they are.
You got any idea what I'm dealing with, huh? I got three deputies, sharing two shotguns, for Christ's sake.
We almost handed the rope up. The guy drives like the devil. And by the time we catch up to him, he's across the state line.
That's because Clyde steals the fastest cars out there while you drive the heaviest cars built. Your cars weren't built for speed, they were built for back roads. That's why even if you caught him, you couldn't catch him.
Who the hell are you?
Frank Hamer.
I contacted the Tyler, Texas Ranger, Captain Frank Hamer. I'm convinced him to accept a commission.
A commission? To do what?
To hunt down Bonnie and Clyde, gentlemen.
Said that they're looking for us in Louisiana and Missouri. Oh, look at this. Escaped with Bonnie Puffin, the ravishing redhead.
Yes, you should.
I just wish there was a picture to go alongside this.
We don't need pictures. Sure, the job is hard enough. The last thing we want is pictures.
I mean, it's just a shame not to have a picture along where it says, ravishing redhead. Or the cover. Who do I gotta hold up, or you gotta hold up, to get my picture on the cover?
We don't need pictures. As soon as someone sees your face, there ain't no way they ever gonna forget.
You're just partial.
Hell I am. I've been thinking about my body from the minute I wake up.
You wrote a song about me. Oh, you are so in love.
That feeling is the best I've ever had.
Ravishing Anna song, it is a fine day.
She is in my shaving mirror. She is in my coffee cup.
This just my.
Are you gonna keep interrupting me? I can't sing if you're gonna keep interrupting me.
I won't say another.
And I've got a rhythm, a flow going here.
Okay.
I would like to write to Bonnie, tell the girl the way I feel, but I'm bitter with a car name with a pain. Used to be I'm only happy when I'm still behind a wheel. Now I don't care if I ever drive. That girl's got something, nothing scares her. Only piece of luck that's ever come my way. I can't wait to tell her how much I've missed her. Feeling sorry for James Gang, cause he's never. Been dreaming about my body just as soon as I'm asleep. They're the kind of dreams that keep you in your bed. I'm making love to Bonnie, and that sure beats counting sheep. Got a feeling there are good times up ahead. Did you hear that?
No.
lights.
Anything?
Shh!
It's Buck!
Clyde, Clyde, hey, anybody follow you?
No, no, I swear.
Just Blanche!
Where's your horse?
They are comfortable and fashionable in the car.
You son of a bitch, you made it!
Your brother's come to try to talk to me coming back.
Blanche?
To give yourself up.
I give myself up, Blanche, and I get the chair. Now, as happy as that'll make you, I think I'm gonna pass. Take a look at this place.
Hey, Buck, did you see Trudy Saxon? They called me a ravishing redhead.
Redhead? Please. That was not a judgment, Lord. Just my professional opinion.
Saying how much she loves you and misses you, and I told her we can come back and see you anytime she wants. We'll find a way. We will always find a way. And I just want you to know that I'm gonna take good care of Bonnie. I love her more than anything in this world. And also, we want you to have this. There's well over $50 there. We know how hard times is, and we just want to help any way we can.
I know how hard this must be for you, Mama, but I swear!
Listen to me, honey!
He loves me!
Honey?
He loves me like a poet, he loves me!
Honey?
I'm okay, I just missed you, that's all.
Listen to me. Ted says you'll only get a prison sentence if you come and drown.
Mama.
While that fire's still and all, it's nothing compared to what may happen before this is over. I'd be much happier with you in prison than like you are, honey.
I'm not gonna leave him!
Listen to me!
Breathing down my damn neck.
What the hell are they getting involved for?
Because Barrow and his brother just broke into the West Texas Army.
What'd they take?
Enough weapons to start a small war.
Holy
including three Browning automatic rifles.
Holy shit.
Holy shit!
Clyde Barrow's head on a stick.
Just get me within 300 yards and I'll put a bullet in his neck.
When it begins, this is murdering people.
It's me, sheriff's office just called. It's been another robbery. The Barrow gang.
How do they know?
Parker signed autographs. Another teller was killed.
Why do folks wanna be heroes? Why do they not stand and tall? Why don't they just hand it over? It ain't their money after all. We won't get to heaven, so let's raise a little hell.
Missouri Police Officer just called. They see two cups of match the description of the barrel gang. Get this. When a neighbor saw them open up the garage door, he spotted what could only be described as a box of guns.
We drive through the night, we could be in Joplin midday tomorrow.
We don't have jurisdiction in Missouri.
I don't give a crap about jurisdiction. I was hired to do a job. Let's go get him.
Short, loving life that ain't so
and rob a bank.
Jesus.
Police nearly caught us, but you should have seen Clyde drive, man.
Oh, Ford Deluxe Sedan don't get no better than that.
Here, you see what I got you, baby.
Did you steal it?
No. I bought it. The money I robbed from the bank.
Heavenly thing. I've ever tasted in my whole life.
Well, you see, I got out of a general store, and the store owner said it was new mail. It was called a, Twinkie.
That was the Goodrich Zippers Orchestra featuring the incomparable Henry Bowe. And now, how about a dance?
Oh, sing for it, sugar. Ladies and gentlemen, that beautiful redhead who held
ravishing
redhead that held up your bank is now gonna hold up your heart with her rendition of How About a Dance. Time to think, you just gotta grit your teeth and you gotta come down home. Then it's over. Doug, you see him lying there. That's life gone. You took it. And he'll never live. Breathe. Laugh again. But you know if he'd have beat you to it, that'd be you there lying like that. It all gets so mixed up. The whole damn business. Them killing us. And us killing them. Makes you wonder why you were ever born. Why anybody was born. And why God should bother with the whole mess. Ain't that right, Sheriff? You need to come with us.
He needs to be in a hospital.
We can't go to a hospital.
He needs a doctor.
We can't go to a doctor.
He's your brother. You're flesh and blood. You're just going to leave him to die.
Blanche, please just come with us.
I am not leaving him. Thank you.
She's got the photos back from the camera, John.
Look at them. They look like they're celebrating.
This is Bonnie and her mom.
What's with the rabbit?
This wasn't taken that long ago. Which means I came back so that Bonnie could see her folks. When's the last time they were in Dallas?
October. Before that, April.
Easter. Explains the rabbit. What were they doing here in October? Halloween? Have you got any pictures of a pumpkin?
What's the date in October?
14.
Bonnie's mother's birthday.
So you're telling me two murders are risking capture just so they can see their folks?
I think so.
And you haven't staked out the parents?
We haven't got the money or the manpower.
Get a wiretap on the parents' phones. Get those pictures to the paper.
We find out where they're headed. We'll hit the town road on that.
We're not opening fire on a moving car.
Yes, we are.
No, we're going to try for the risk.
They shut their way. Nine officers don't. And the sheriff.
Mike Barrow has no intention of giving himself up, ever.
What about Bonnie?
Her fate was sealed the day she broke him out of Easter. The next time they see their folks will be their last.
Honey.
What?
Ryan,
Hey.